All right, welcome to Vectorworks 2020 with completely redone icons, other than all the videos that I've been making for you all summer long. But oh well, they're actually pretty much the same. They've just made them look a little more cutesy or something. But hopefully you can follow along and find the icons in the other 2019 tutorials that I've been making. So this is a brief tutorial about the stairs and ramp options that you have here. You're probably going to want to create some kind of height in there. And I'm not going to go into great detail on this because a lot of this stuff is fairly self-explanatory. You just need to kind of poke around a little bit and make the changes. There's so many options, so many different things that you can do. I'm just going to show you where to start poking around, and hopefully that will give you what you need. So to create a simple staircase like this guy right here, we're going to use the simple stair tool, and that's going to be in the spotlight workspace. So we're in the spotlight workspace. Probably you're in that workspace. If not, you can go here to the tools menu and find workspaces down at the bottom and select spotlight workspace. But we're going to jump over here to the architect workspace in a second. But right now we can find under the building shell, that's the one that looks like a little house, the tools that we use to create building-like objects. And one of them is the simple stair tool. And I've got a little stair loaded already here floating around in my cursor. If I clicked in here, I would create a staircase. But before I do that, I'm going to come and find the pencil and wrench tool there, the preferences tool. And that's going to open up a fairly simple set of parameters that you can change here. You can change it from an open riser to a masonry style. That's the going all the way to the floor like I have over here. You can play around with these and see what you think. I'm just going to create an open riser. Width is pretty self-explanatory, 3 foot, floor-to-floor height. And that's probably going to be defaulted to 9 foot 1 inch, which is a typical residential floor-to-floor height. But oftentimes we do 8 foot, like this platform here is at 8 foot. You can set the max riser height. You probably don't want to go more than 8 inches unless it's a special situation. Tread depth is how deep your steps are. If you want to add some nosing, set this to something other than 0. Tread height would be if we do this open staircase, how thick is the piece of wood that we're stepping on as the steps? And then if you have a landing, if you've got something that has a landing in it, like this configuration here, we can just make a straight staircase or straight with a landing on the right, landing on the left. You know, we have some options here. So let's just grab landing left, and then it's going to say, well, what step do you want this landing to be on? So right here, this is the fifth step up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here it's set to 8. We'll give that a try. We'll see what we think. You can make the landing curved. Lots of different things that you can do. Pretty much click down these buttons and you can see what they do. They're pretty straightforward. I'm going to say OK, and I'm going to click once and click twice in case I wanted to rotate it. And now I can see that I've got a nice little staircase here with a landing on the 8 foot mark. And the nice thing is that the object info has pretty much all of those things available to you. So if you decide, oh no, maybe actually I do want the standard stairs, or maybe I do want it to be indented here, the other versions that we didn't talk about. Maybe I do want to go back to the masonry style. You have the ability to just select these from this list here. It's very simple to do that. If you decide you want to change the height of the stair or the width of the stair, let's make them really skinny. We'll make them 2 foot thin. We're doing a little escape stair or something on the back of the set, so they're only 2 foot thick. We want to make the landing height on the fourth step up instead of the eighth step up. We can do that and just hit enter, and then it has turned the landing around there. And I don't know if I did I select that? There we go. And we can swing it in different directions. We can change the height. All of these things are here. You can even give yourself sort of simple handrails there. So that's a simple stair tool. It is really simple. It's very easy to use. And pretty much all of the options here are fairly self-explanatory in the object info. But let's look at how do you create these more advanced stairs. So spiral staircases and things with more complicated tools. Well, we need to jump over here under the tools menu to the workspaces and just go to any one of these architecture ones. I think these top three here will give you the tool we're looking for. So we'll just jump over to the architect workspace, and it's going to take a second to redraw the workspace and bring in all the tools from the architecture tool set. And as soon as it's done loading in all those tools, we'll be able to jump to that same tool set, building shell tools here. So same tool set, and we're looking for this little tool here. We're going to click on the stair tool, and then it's going to give us that same kind of like stair ready to go. But I'm going to click on that pencil and wrench settings there, and I'm going to open that up and take a look at this. Now this is much more complicated. I already have it set up for my little spiral staircase. It's probably not going to look like this to begin with. You'll see under standard configuration, it's probably just going to be a straight stair, so we'll just switch it to that. This is probably what you're going to see when you're going to open it up. Now, this is an architect's tool, and it's much more complicated. In fact, even the architects don't like it. They're always complaining about it on the on the forums. This is a tool that allows you to do a whole lot more settings than what we have. But if you can do pretty much all of this with a simple Stair tool. So probably what you're going to want to do is, if you're in this tool, you're probably trying to do something with curves in it. So we can click on the select standard configuration. A lot of these are going to be the same as to what we have in the simple Stair tool, except for that circular Stair. So if we grab that little circular Stair and we say okay, and then now we have a bunch of options. So we have the same floor to floor height value, tread depth, all these kinds of things. You know, before I do anything else here, actually, let's take a look at the railings. One really kind of silly thing that it does is it puts railings on both sides. So we're going to want to make sure that the inside railing here does not have a guardrail. So we're going to click on the guardrail, deselect that guardrail, and deselect the handrail. Okay, that's off. So that way it's not twisting a railing around that center post in there. But you can play around with a lot of these different things. There's various railing styles you can play around with. You can switch which style they're on. If you go to the construction tab, you can say, do we want it to be, you know, open, stringer underneath? Again, just take a look at all these little check boxes here. You can switch it here to circular stair. It can do that default circular stair options for you. And then when you're happy, go ahead and click OK, and then you can insert the staircase. So there it is on my cursor. I'm just going to double click to insert it into the scene. And then I can go back now all the way back to Spotlight. I can switch back to Spotlight because once you've inserted the staircase, you can continue to edit it in the object info and you can make a copy of it. If you decide you want another one, you can just make a copy of this staircase and it's going to have links to those more advanced options on it. So with the stair still selected, now I can go back to the settings, clicking this little button right here in the object info, and it takes me right back where I was. So you can continue to tweak these tools here to make that stair more what you want. So there we go. We've got a sort of typical spiral staircase in there, and I'll let you kind of play around with exploring the various options. But that's how you bring in a spiral staircase into your scene. And then the same thing, this one was created the same way, except I did not make it a spiral staircase. I just did a curved staircase, and I play with the inside and outside diameter and that kind of thing. I want to quickly show you the ramp tool. So back here, even in Spotlight, we have the ramp tool. Ramp tool is really set up by default for like wheelchair access ramps. So if we click in a basic ramp, it's going to be huge. Let me get back to the selection tool. Take a look over here in the ramp settings here. We can set the standard to masonry. That's going to just put that slab underneath it. And then you're probably going to want something on stage that's not quite so high. So maybe we're going to, maybe it's 3 foot wide and it's going up 3 feet, but we can get much higher rise over run. It can be much steeper. If we make that like 2 inches, that's going to be really steep, a steep ramp, but it's going to be, you know, something more like what we're actually going to be able to use on stage. Now you can't do a curve landing. You can do various landings on here. So you can do landing right, you know, you can sort of bend it around, put it in different positions here, and then change all of these basic parameters in here. But if you want to do a curving ramp like this, there's actually a couple of ways that you can do this. There's a little cheat that you can do that's actually pretty slick. If you go over here into the wall tool, so we're still in the same building shell, we're going to click on the round wall tool, and I'm just going to click and I'm going to do a little half round wall here. I'm just kind of clicking into a shape there. So now I've got a round wall, that's kind of slick, and I can pretend that this wall is actually a ramp quite easily by going in and setting the thickness to say 3 feet, and then we're going to make it much less tall than that. Let's say, well, we'll do 3 feet as well, 36 inches for that. And then if I hit enter, then it's dropped down. We've got this kind of little sort of benchy looking thing. Well, if I use the selection tool and I double click on the tool here, I get these little control points, and these little control points here and here allow me to click and drag down to make a slanting wall. If I wanted a wall that, you know, had an angle on it, I could do that with any of the wall tools. But here, by doing that, I've kind of created a little curved ramp by turning a wall into a ramp. If I wanted to make that even thicker, I could go over here and say, let's try 6 feet. Let's see if we could double it. Yeah. So now we've got this kind of nice round curvy ramp. So those are some ways that you can create some curved ramps. But we can also use, I'll show you one other way that we can do this. I just got two rectangles just drawn in 2D here. We can use a command up here under model called multiple extrude. Basically what this is doing is it's going to extrude the first shape, and instead of going straight up, it's going to go up to the height of the next shape here. So if I select multiple extrude, and then I say I want that extrusion to be, we'll make it a little steeper, we'll make it 2 feet, and I'll say okay. Now I've created another way to make a ramp, and I can make this rectangle smaller, or I can make it an entirely different shape. You can even convert between two different shapes. You can do a square into a circle and all kinds of things with multiple extrude. So those are various ways that you can create ways to get up between levels in your models.